in Spiritum Sanctum Dominum et vivificante. Et in Spiritum Sanctum Dominum et vivificantem, Spiritum Sanctum, Spiritum Sanctum, vivificantem, vivificantem Domini, qui ex Patre Filio de Proce.
Some of my favorite movements in the B minor Mass are where we can find examples of Bach using symbolism, a kind of hidden symbolism that you can see on the page, but you won't necessarily hear unless you're listening out for it. The idea that God is visible and invisible. Crucifixus is actually, interestingly, the earliest music that he draws from in the piece. It's a parody of Cantata 12. The original text is Weinen, Klagen, Sorgen, Zagen, weeping, lamenting, etc. It's a really slow lament, but here it transforms into the graphic picture of the crucifixion. Crucifixus, a ground bass that becomes inevitable and throbbing with the idea of nails being slammed into the limbs every few bars. The words passus, supponsio pilato is one of the most extraordinary moments of injustice in music.
I was very much moved by the Christian symbolism that is present in the artwork. Of course, the image of the cross on which our Savior died, the chalice, which is the sacrifice and the place through which forgiveness of sins happens, and the altar, which is covered in red as a symbol of blood. And of course, our cathedral, which is known as the red and white building here in London because of the brick from outside, but especially because of its dedication. The cathedral is dedicated to the precious blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, King and Redeemer.
The Vaughan Scholar's main role is singing at the school's liturgies. That's why the choir was founded, and it continues to this day to be the main role. Although we do lots of very exciting things, the boys sing in the chorus at Covent Garden, and we've been lucky enough to be involved in lots of big films, and we also are very lucky that we come and sing here at the cathedral. But nonetheless, the core and the main focus, the main activity is focused on the school's weekly Mass.
For sure, making music definitely puts me, I think, in touch with the idea that there's something bigger than us and that community is so important. I actually grew up in a very atheist kind of family. There was not much belief within the household. But as I've got older and I've been in contact with this kind of music, it's definitely brought me to a place where my belief in not living so individualistically. And I think that this space and this music and the messages will always be relevant and human. And I think there is really important.
In my opinion, music is an integral part of our faith tradition. God speaks to each of us in different ways, and music is a universal language. I think the music of Bach, the Mass in B minor, is a case in point that a secular person could listen to that music and be moved by it without necessarily A, understanding, or B, agreeing with the words. Now, of course, Credo in Unum Deum, I believe in one God, is the linchpin of the Christian faith.
The music here is essential to the life of the worship of our cathedral. It doesn't just enhance. It is an essential part, integral part of what we do, really. It enables people to reflect and take part in a different way than just responding. That, you know, the music lifts their mind, their heart, and their soul to God. And also, it helps them to see responses is sometimes in silence and listening as well as sharing together. And so the music in so many different ways enhances what's the liturgical celebrations express here. And it does add so many more dimensions. One of the lovely things is that one of the essential parts of cathedral life is the singing of the office. And so with having the choirs that enables that to continue on a daily basis.
Music, I think, has that power to go beyond spoken word, to touch parts of our intellect and our thought that spoken text cannot. And music has the power to transform us. And I think Bach has that particular opportunity with people both of religious faith and non-religious faith, which is perhaps why he is one of the best known composers. He had the same role as me, which was to try and bring that transformative music to the people. It's wonderful to think that the work that I do and that our choristers and singers here do is in that tradition.